Hi, I'm Steve Demme, and I'm going to be brainstorming with you again and sharing another idea of an activity that your family might want to partake of. A good friend of mine calls fire, and he's thinking mostly of a campfire or a fire in a fireplace. He calls it a thinking man's TV. I don't know how many times I've thought of that as I sit quietly looking at logs burning in our little cabin we have up in the mountains, or outdoor in a fire pit, or at home in our fireplace. But there's something relaxing, soothing, and when you do have an outdoor fire pit, there's really nothing like it for families to gather around a fire, turn off all electronic media, and just talk and visit and just be in each other's presence. Fire, there's something, I don't know what it is, but there's something nice about fires. And even in the New Testament, dear Peter had denied Jesus over a charcoal fire. And I don't know if you're aware of this, but there's only two times in the New Testament that expression is used, charcoal fire. And the first one was where Peter denied Jesus, and the second one was where Peter was restored by Jesus. So Peter and his buddies were out fishing all night, and they noticed on shore that somebody was beckoning them, and they finally figured out it was Jesus, and they got out of their boat, and there was a charcoal fire. Precious. Jesus knew that Peter needed to be healed, and that memory, he smelled that charcoal fire, and his first thought was probably, oh, this is where I denied my Savior. But now Jesus turned that into a sweet memory, because he restored Peter over a charcoal fire that he'd built for them and made breakfast for his companions. So, something special about fires. Now, when do you have fires? I know one family that has a fire every Friday night. They call them Friday fires, and the family looks forward to their Friday fire night. I'm sure that they make s'mores and different traditions. All I know is that they were sharing with me that they look forward to Friday fire night. So one night when the kids were young, we decided to have a camp out near a fireplace in our home. And what we did was we arranged to have a rope go across from the mantle of the fireplace to a windowsill across the room, and we draped over it a sheet or a blanket of some sort and held it down with chairs, and that became our tent. And the boys had their little pillows in there and their little sleeping bags. And then Sandy, bless her heart, she brought in a little red wagon like we were on a cattle drive. And she brought in this little red wagon, and we all had our cowboy hats on and our bandanas around our neck. And in the wagon, she had baked beans. She had some plates and some silverware. And I don't remember, I think we may have cooked our hot dogs on the fire with sticks. But you know, you have to have a tarp down so you don't wreck the carpet. But that's a precious memory for the kids. Even better sometimes is just to go outside, have a campfire in your backyard, set up a tent, make a meal over that campfire. But one of the reasons that we're having activities is so we can get closer together as families, but also to create memories. And I have a memory of a wonderful camp wagon fire when my kids were younger that I've never lost. And I have memories of fires to this day. And I've been told that the sense of smell is one of the big triggers in our memories. And so fires can be very positive to that end. So whether you're having them in your den or out in an outdoor fire pit, let me encourage you to have family fires as a possible activity to help your family develop some memories. Thank you, Father, for restoring Peter over the same charcoal fire where he denied you. Thank you for giving us families and help us to develop memories, positive memories, and experiences that will be a part of the warp and woof of our memories of our childhood. In Jesus' name, amen.